What's good, everybody on YouTube? I'm back with another one, and today I got the Kobe 1 Protro Star Power. Now, as you can see, the official colorway on these are white, black, and varsity red. As far as the box goes, you got your black box, Kobe signature on the top. Let's just jump into the shoe because I got a lot to talk about. First and foremost, I do want to say you can go true to size on these. I found that I had slight heel slippage, but not much. This is a dope shoe, good on court. I'm gonna tell you right now, this is a true basketball shoe. Now, as far as laces, you got rope laces with your silver tips on the end. Great quality. I love to see different style laces. Now, this sneaker does feature full length zoom, unlike the original model, and does have this slight tumbled leather. What I would say is not the best, but it's not bad. And it does have a knitted upper. Inside of the shoe right here, you can see it has this sort of crumbled leather texture. I don't know. I like it because it's different. But to some people, it could probably be a turnoff. I would say with these, you may have to break them in, but it wouldn't take a long time. I could see one or two games or a couple of wears and they should be broken in. Now, I will say this sneaker on the traction scale, I would have to give it probably about a 9.5. And I'm only saying that because this sneaker does have like this wide flat outsole, which does give you like real good traction, like on another level. And I do understand because it's Kobe Bryant. Like they couldn't put something out that felt like a ultra boost on court. So in that aspect, yes, I would have to give it a 2 thumbs up. Now, as far as the outsole, red, black, and white colorway. And this sneaker does also feature a carbon fiber shank plate. You do have your Nike swoosh on the bottom. And also, you do have your Zoom Air stamp. This is a shoe that I definitely think that if you're a basketball player, you should grab. Now, on your insoles, you do have these little holes for like breathing. Of course, they expect intense gameplay in these, so that's a given. Now, we're going to take a closer look at this leather and these rope laces. Now, as far as this leather goes, like I said, it's not bad quality, but it's not the best. But I'm not going to keep y'all long. I just want to mention pricing right quick. These were $175, more like $185 with tax, which I think is a bit high. I think this should have been more in the $150 range. But yeah, man, we're gonna jump into this on foot. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. I appreciate y'all. And we're gonna jump into this on foot. And like I said, I'm gonna catch y'all on the next one. Peace.
When you see us, you know we mean business.
It's hammer. I'll say that name, motherfucker. Shout out my nigga DJ Bang, man. Let's get it. Oh,